Hey everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you all the updates that have occurred within version 1.1.9 of warrantoffkeys commands. If you've used a previous version of warrantoffkeys commands, please keep in mind that there are multiple breaking changes, the first of which is going to be how the constructor works. Previously, there was a number of different arguments you can pass in, but now, as there are more and more features requested, I opted in for this object here, which is going to contain all of the previous arguments and anything new that might be added in the future. So here we see the commands and features directory. We see the message path. We also see some new things such as a show warnings boolean and also a test servers array, which can technically be a string. But of course, if you want multiple test servers, you'll have to add in an array. I'll explain what test servers are in a moment, but we also need to discuss some changes to the commands. Previously, there was a number of different arguments you had to pass in a specific order, but now, similar to the constructor, there is an object where you can destructure these. So in the previous versions, if you wanted access to the instance, you'd have to add in args and text and everything else. But now because it's an object, you can just simply destructure instance. You don't have to pass in all the unnecessary things that you might not need for that exact command. The one downside to this is that the spelling has to be exactly how warrantoffkeys commands expect it. So if we go to the documentation and go to creating a command, we can scroll down and we can see the exact spelling right here. So for example, if you have arguments spelt out as the full word, it will not actually be able to get the args because this is spelt with these four characters here. Next up, I'm going to show you how you can use the different test servers, which are useful if you want to deploy some commands or features to your actual bot server, but you don't want them to be enabled on every single server yet. So to do this for a command, you can simply just specify test only is true. And to do this for a feature, you have to pass in this third argument here, which is going to be a method. In the future, this will return if it is enabled within a certain guild. So it's important to add in your guild is enabled checks earlier rather than later, because this will be added in the future. However, we first just have to gain access to the guild, ensure it exists, and then see if this feature is enabled within this guild. And all this feature does is just simply console log the actual content of each message that is sent. We also have to specify test only is true within our exported configuration object. And again, keep in mind that you do have to call is enabled before any of your actual logic. If I did not have this and we were in a test server or in any other server, this would still work just like normal. The next thing is how you can configure the emojis per command category, as well as setting hidden categories. So previously you'd have to call multiple methods and chain them together to set multiple different emojis for categories. However, now you can pass in an array of objects that looks like this. You can override the default one, such as configuration here, or you can add in your own categories and set the emoji just like normal. We also see this hidden property, which is set to true, and this will make it so non-administrators running the help command will not see that in the menu. For example, if I do exclamation point help, I will still see the configuration here because I'm an administrator, but anyone else running this will not. We also have guild only servers, which you can specify guild only is true. We also have guild only commands. So you can specify guild only is true right here within the command syntax. And that's going to make it so it'll send an error if you ever try and use this within a direct message. There's only a couple more things, such as the ability to show default warnings, as well as the ability to set a certain color. So this is going to be used for the actual help menu embed. As you see here, it is red, which is the hex color we use here. And so any future embeds that are going to be used within warrantoffkeys commands will be able to use this color. And the last thing that was added is if we go to the documentation and we go to setup, you can specify the MongoDB options here. These are the defaults. So if you want these, you don't have to specify anything, but if you want to change these values or add in other defaults, you can pass them into the DB options object, which is passed inside of the main options object for the constructor. And that's everything. That's everything added in version 1.1.9 of warrantoffkeys commands. If you have any feature requests or bug reports, feel free to leave a comment down below or post them within the warrantoffkeys Discord server. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the warrantoffkeys Discord, which can be found in the video description.